We're going to look at the practice to feel love and joy within your heart. And this is the Vedic philosophy, and it's based on the Hare Krishna chant. So I'll tell you a little story. After my experience of unity consciousness in 1995, I became deeply aware of being taught and guided by enlightened divine beings. So I was not surprised 2 years later when I became aware through direct intuition in my heart center that a great enlightened spiritual master was visiting England. I knew I had to find this person. It was a part of my mission to experience his or her presence. So I began my search in total confidence and faith that I would find and meet such a great master, because I already knew they were coming. So you will not be surprised when I tell you that I was approached in Cheltenham's High Street by a Hare Krishna devotee. When I shared with him my quest, he replied, "Wow, that's an interesting thing, because our leader from India is visiting us next month. We'll be holding meetings for us in Wales." Yes, it was the spiritual leader I was destined to meet. And through our personal meeting, I was given confirmation of the part that the Krishna consciousness has to play in the teaching of unconditional love to all of humanity. So now I will offer you a little of their historical background for your interest. So if in any way your religious beliefs are in conflict with the chanting of Hare Krishna, I apologize to you. Please do not worry, because you do not have to chant this sacred mantra, which is connecting you to the unconditional love of God, because we are showing you more than one way to make this heart connection. So Hare Krishna, overview and background. The Vedic scriptures state that spiritual life begins when one inquires into the nature of the absolute truth, the supreme Godhead. The Vedics know the personality of Godhead as Krishna, the all-attractive. But it's also recognized that the Supreme has unlimited names, such as Rama, Buddha, Vishnu, Jehovah, Allah, Christ, God, etc. So really, what they're embracing is, and what their objective is, to develop a loving relationship with the Supreme Godhead. So if you can view it in this way, it becomes acceptable to all faiths and beliefs. The Vedas also tell us that the understanding of the self as being non-material is transcendental by nature. This is the preliminary stage of realization of the absolute truth. To understand knowledge of self-realization, one must approach a genuine spiritual master, just as one learns the essence of any spirit or any subject from a perfected practitioner. The congregational chanting of the Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, as promoted by the Krishna organization, is accepted by the Vedas as the most effective means of self-purification in this age. The Vedas describe this mantra as a prayer to the Lord. Please, Lord, engage me in your service. Some devotional songs have been popularized by Western artists, as you're probably aware, including George Harrison, for example. So this is the mantra to connect your heart to unconditional universal love. This mantra is a transcendental sound vibration which awakens God's love in your heart and mind. And this is what it sounds like. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And you just keep repeating this over and over again. So the ultimate goal of chanting Hare Krishna is to develop a loving relationship with the Supreme Godhead. The chanting of this mantra is accepted by the Vedas as the most effective means of self-purification in the age. You could say that this chant, without any philosophy or ideology, can be used in conjunction with any faith or belief, and that you may already hold and treasure. Think of the chant as a direct pathway to the beloved universal divine consciousness, providing you with the quality of unconditional love. I think all faiths in the world would promote such a fantastic quality manifesting in your life. And the thing to do is to keep repeatedly chant this for a short period of time. But what I noticed is it's the way you chant it. If you chant it with devotional love, as if you're making love to your supreme lover, and then be quiet and feel and listen afterwards, you will feel the quality come into your mind and your heart.